السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله تعالى we'll go through سورة البروج. We'll start سورة البروج and it's سورة number 85. And it's سورة number 85 سورة البروج. And as usual we talk first about the surah, some of the things that we need to do with one surah after the other. Surah Al-Buruj, it's called Al-Buruj. This is the name of the surah because it's mentioned in the first ayah, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوج, and السَّمَاءِ with the great stars or so. So Al-Buruj, as it will come inshallah ta'ala, is the meaning of, or one of the words that means the stars. And there's no like of that word in the Quran. So it was said that Surah Al-Buruj was revealed in order of the Surah numbers 27, came down after Surah Al-Shams and before Surah At-Teen. After Surah Al-Shams and before Surah At-Teen. And as we said, this order or this specific order with times, there's not like perfect authenticity about it, but this is something that is mentioned in the books of the Tafsir with regards to how the surahs were revealed in that particular time order. But as we know that the orders of the verses in the Quran has been done by the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, or at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The surah is 22 verses and it's a Makki surah. It was revealed in Mecca. And it talks about those who tortured and were fitna and a trial for the Muslimin in general, whether it's in Mecca, reminding them of what happened to the nations before, and specifically the story of Ashabul Ukhdud, the companion of the trench, or what the Prophet ﷺ described in details, the hadith of the boy and Al-Ghulam wa-Sahir wa-Rahib, and the sorcerer and the worshipper, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this trial for the people, and how that the entire nation or the entire people that this boy was a reason for them to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were all killed by their evil king, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this as their victory, is for them to die in the state of Al-Islam and for to be patient and to be firm upon the faith, and to show that the reality of this life is, it's the objective of it is to be obedient to Allah, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So if someone fulfilled his objective in this life, it doesn't matter really what happens in his life. Everything is by the qadr of Allah. And that evil, or as what the evil of the disbelievers they do to the believers, is part of this life. And it's part of being tested whether to be patient with the orders of Allah or not. So this was revealed to the Prophet ﷺ to give steadfastness to the Prophet ﷺ and the companions radiallahu anhum, and more of course of the important meanings in the surah. So let's start inshallah ta'ala by reciting and reciting in a proper way, and we'll try to take the first 10 verses or so, and then the rest inshallah ta'ala will continue the next time, or 11 verses. So let's start inshallah ta'ala from verse number 1 to verse number 11. Repeat after me inshallah, raise your voice so that with the intention of learning how to recite it with tajweed, and make sure that you also memorize it or review it if you have it memorized. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. والسماء ذات البروج. والسماء four counts. ذات البروج باء هذا ضمة. بروج, and you stop with the قلقلة because the جيم is one of the letters of قطب جد. واليوم الموعود. واليوم الموعود. The قلقلة again at the end. وشاهد ومشهود. وَشَاهِدِينُ تنوين after 12 is إضغام with the tone with the غنة, and at the end we stop with the خلقلة. قتل أصحاب الأخدود. It's easy إن شاء الله. وذاك القلق at the end. النار ذات الوقود. النار, the noon والشدة takes two counts. ذات الوقود. إذ هم عليها قعود. وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود. وما نقموا منهم إلا أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد. وما نقموا منهم إلا مد أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض والله على كل شيء شهيد. والله على كل شيء إخفاء شهيد. Number 10. إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا. ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق. The last ayah today, inshallah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ يفتو إخفاء here with the ta. لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ذلك الفوز الكبير. So let's go through the verses inshallah. The first ayah was والسماء ذات البروج, by the sky containing great stars. So this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by some of his creation, as we heard that many times in the Quran. Signs from Allah, these creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are signs from Allah. And al-buruj, stars, or the places where the sun and the moon and the stars, they have a fixed place in its orbit, fixed in an orbit in the most perfect way, which shows the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the great power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whether al-buruj here refers to the great stars, right, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا, in Surah Al-Furqan. Blessed is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that made in the skies بروجا. And the بروج, as they said, whether it's the stars or the guards, right, or, you know, because the بروج also in Arabic means some fortified places, some very strong, mighty structures. Right, so again, this is al-buruj, was-sama'i dhati al-buruj, and what we see with our eyes. Allah knows best how great this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Was-sama'i dhati al-buruj, wal-yawmi al-maw'ud, and the promised day, which is yawm al-qiyamah. Al-yawm al-maw'ud is the day of al-qiyamah. And it's called al-maw'ud because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised his khalq, his creation, that he will gather them in it. And the first of them and the last of them will be present in the day of Al-Qiyamah. You know, it's no one is able to change it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's promise is the truth. And what's mentioned in the details of Yawm Al-Qiyamah, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ, a group in Jannah, a group in Hawfair. So all the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as promised in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet will be fulfilled in the most perfect way. So وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ, the awaiting day or the promised day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by it. وشاهدي ومشهود, and by the witness and what is witnessed. This is in general, right? وشاهد, any شاهد, any witness, and any مشهود, anything that is being witnessed, right? So this is swearing by one of the signs of Allah that that there is a, as a fact of life, that there is something to be witnessed and there's a witness, right? So this is in general, again, as we said. And the same thing, وَالْيَوْمَ well, الْمَوْعُود is referring to the Day of Judgment. But some people, for example, when they say other things, what is the promised day or so, but here, شَهِدٌ وَمَشْهُود is when some said, for example, in the tafsir of it, that it's the Day of Jumu'ah, and يَوْمٌ and the مَشْهُود is the Day of Al-Qiyamah. Right, or when some said it's the day of Jumu'ah, Shahid, and the Mashhud is the day of Arafah, and the Maw'ud is Yawm al-Qiyamah, you know, three major days. And some said the Shahid, the witness, is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Mashhud is the day of Al-Qiyamah. So many different things that is said, and it's part of the tafsir with an example. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by every shahid, every witness, and every mashhud, and everything that is witnessed. Yeah, and these days also, the day of Jumu'ah, the day of Arafah, these are witness days, of course. Right? So again, wa shahidin wa mashhud, Allah knows best, but this is what is mentioned with regards to a shahid and mashhud. That's everything. Right? The same thing, anything that has been seen, you know, anything that is witnessed, and this is all from the signs of Allah. Then the answer to this, to these things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by, what is it? Kutila ashabul ukhdud, which means destroyed were the companions of the trench. Kutila ashabul ukhdud, this is a dua against them that they will be perished. The people of al-ukhdud is the trench, or the when people dig on the ground, as making holes in the ground. Ashab al-Ukhdud, this is the story of the people of al-Ukhdud. They were disbelievers, and among them there were believers, and they tried to make the believers that renegade away from faith, but the believers, they refused. And as it's mentioned, the story of the boy and the king. So when the disbelievers, they found the resistance from the believers, they made these trenches in the ground, and they put the believers in it, and they put fire in it, and they threw the believers in it. So, and anyone that is to be, you know, tested and tried before they are thrown into the fire. So they would bring them one after the other, and they would tell them, renegade from your deen, or you're going to be thrown into the fire. So the believers, they were firm and steadfast, and they did not renegade away from their deen. They did not change their religion. They did not compromise their religion, even if they were thrown into the fire. And as a result of that, once they're thrown into the fire, they receive the promise of Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed his favor upon them, and they're among the people of Jannah. And this is even when the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that those who spoke in the cradle, one of which is that child, that the woman with her child, carrying the child, infant, and she was part of the believers, and when she was tested before thrown into the fire, and she hesitated because of her child, out of the love towards her child, like every mother, and the child spoke. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the child to speak to his mother and to say, and he said to her, Ya Amah, or you, O slave of Allah, be firm upon your faith, and she was firm, and as a result of that, they died, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed his favor upon them. So, kutila ashabul ukhdud, an-nari dhat al-uqud, containing the fire full of fuel. and that's the tafsir of al-ukhdud, that an-nari dhat al-uqud, right? The fire full of fuel. Idhum alayha qu'ud, when they were sitting near it. Right? And this is, they were sitting near it, and that's how they were evil and doing these evil actions. And nari dhati al-uqud, idhum alayha qu'ud, and kutila ashabul ukhdud, they're perished, they're destroyed. It's also one of the meaning of they are being cursed, and they will be in the hellfire forever. And how evil they are, when they dug the trenches, when they put fire in it, and they were sitting by it, and they would not accept anything from the people except to disbelief. Otherwise, they would be thrown into the fire. إِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُودٌ وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ شُهُودٌ. And they were what they're doing against the believers. They were witnesses. They were witnessing what they're doing to the believers while they're sitting there, witnessing what's happening, seeing what's happening to the believers, throwing them into the fire. وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا أَن يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَكِيمِ. And they resented them not except because they believed in Allah. This is the only crime that these believers committed, is that they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Aziz al-Hamid, the exalted in might, the praiseworthy. So this is why they are being punished. Not because of any crime that they committed, except that the fact that they are believers. And that's the hatred of some of the disbelievers to the believers, is just because of that. And they might say things, as Fir'aun said about Musa alayhi salam and the people, they would lie about them. But this is the real intentions, or the real enmity is there because they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's mentioned here that they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that no one can defeat him. And he's the one that is full of praise and so on. And that's even that he's the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believers, they were not saved in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permitted for them to be destroyed and to be thrown into the fire. And that's by the izzah of Allah. This is by the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all. But again, as we said, it's because we value this life so much. When human beings, they value their life so much, when we read the revelation of Allah, this life is not valued to Allah. This life is there for people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, and this is one of the things that people, you know, they deviate because of these types of things, because they don't understand the purpose of this life. So, وَمَا نَقَمُ مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. The only crime that they had is, which is not a crime, is that they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Aziz al-Hakim, Al-Hamid. And the ulama, they said that this was the people of Al-Ukhdud, is basically what the Prophet ﷺ described of the hadith of the boy and the sorcerer. And this is, you know, the people of the tafsir, they were different among themselves, whether, you know, who are these people, whether in their Yemen or Persia, it doesn't matter where they place and what, you know, who are they with their names, Allah knows best. And that's why what's mentioned in the story is what matters for people to benefit from it, and especially with those who are, you know, being oppressed or weak and so on. So وَمَا نَقَمُ مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and Allah over all things, is witness. And the subject of witness is mentioned more than one time. So talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that these believers, they believed in, and that's their crime to the disbelievers. They believed in Allah is the only one worthy of worship, and he's the Almighty, the one that has the perfect praise, the one that belongs to him the dominions of the heavens and the earth, and everybody in the creation of Allah are under the power of Allah. Wallahu ala kulli shayin shaheed, and he's all witness over all things, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he would bring everyone to his justice, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no one does anything without the witnessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will be judged accordingly. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُوا فَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمَ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ الْحَرِيقِ. Indeed, those who have tortured the believing men and believing women and then have not repented will have the punishment of hell, and they will have the punishment of the burning fire. And this is a punishment of those who torture the believers. And the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yu'adhib, Allah torture, الَّذِينَ يُعَذِّبُونَ النَّاسِ, those who torture the people. Their punishment will be from the same sort of deed that they did, unless they repent to Allah. And that's as Al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said, انظروا إلى هذا الكرم والجود. When you look at this ayah, he said, look at the generosity of Allah. هم قتلوا أولياء. These disbelievers, they killed awliyaullah, the people of Allah, the believers, and those who are obedient to Allah. وهو يدعوهم إلى التوبة. And he is, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is calling them to tawbah, to repentance. So, إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين, those who tortured the believing men and women, ثم لم يتوبوا, and they did not repent. That means if they have repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would have not been punished by Allah. فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق. For them is the punishment of the fire and the punishment of الحريق, the punishment of the burning fire. So this is the amazing mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to those who torture the believers and those who are evildoers. It's always appropriate in this context to mention the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, the boy in the sorcerer. Inshallah, you know, after we finish the surah, we'll inshallah ta'ala mention this hadith of what the Prophet ﷺ said about that story in details, as it was said to be, this is the same. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, says that those who tortured and fatanu, and fitna, one of the meanings of fitna in the Quran, comes with the meaning of burning. Right, so those who did that to the believers, they would have the same punishment from the same sort of deed that they had. That's why it's mentioned عذاب جهنم and عذاب الحريق, because they torture the believers with the fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them with the punishment of Jahannam and the punishment of being burned in the hellfire. And the last ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ ذلك الفوز الكبير. Indeed, those who have believed and done righteous deeds will have gardens beneath which rivers flow. That is the great attainment. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the punishment of the disbelievers, He mentioned the promise that He promised the believers. And this is the great win from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who at the end, who's the one that is tortured and who's the one that suffers? The disbelievers. The believers, it's not just maybe for a few seconds in this life, but they return to the everlasting rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as for the disbelievers, they enjoyed years or times of tyranny and things like this, but then they return to the everlasting punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the justice of Allah and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that people should benefit from. When we see the words, you know, briefly, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجَ السَّمَاءُ comes from سِينْ مِيمْ وَاوْ ذَاتِ buruj, the one that contains or has buruj, comes from ba'ra jim. And al-buruj, whether it's the stars or constellations or the places or fortified places and things like this, is all called buruj. And al-burj is the tower. You know, one of the use of it nowadays is the towers. So this is all, you know, from the same meaning. واليوم المعود, and the day that is promised, المعود from وعد, وشاهد ومشهود, witness from شين هاء دال, and الشهادة and witnessing, وشاهد ومشهود, and the one that is witnessed, قتل أصحاب الأهد, قتل from قتل, killed or so, but here means destroyed or cursed, أصحاب the companions from صاد حاء بي باء, الأخدود is the pit or the hole in the ground, from خاء دال دال. So this is al-ukhdud. Al-nari dhati al-waqud, the nar or the fire. That al-waqud, al-waqud is the fuel. From waw, qaf, dal. From waw, qaf, dal. Idh, which means here again, when. Idh hum alayha qu'ud. When they were upon it, qu'ud, sitting, qaf, ayn, dal. Qaf, ayn, dal, from qa'da, sitting. وهم على ما يفعلون, and they are upon what they did, يفعلون, were doing, from فعل, بالمؤمنين, to the believers, شهود, witnesses, from شين, هاء, دال. وما نقموا, and they نقموا, from نون, قاف, ميم, which means resented, hated, angry with them because of, you know, النقمة is the punishment. النقمة is the, comes even from revenge, to take revenge. Al-intiqam is to revenge. So they did not revenge or resent from the believer, minhum, from them, illa, except أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز. That they believed in Allah سبحانه وتعالى العزيز الحميد, the Almighty العزيز, from عين زين زين زين, الحميد, the praiseworthy, the worthy, from حاء ميم دال, الذي له ملك السماوات, the one that has the ملك, the dominion of the heavens, السماوات والأرض, and the earth, والله على كل شيء شهيد, and he سبحانه وتعالى is upon all things شهيد or witness. From Shahida again, and then إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا إن الذين فتنوا فتنوا, that means they from fitna, فتن, persecuted, punished, many different meanings to the word fitna. فتن المؤمنين, the believing men and women, والمؤمنات. When the المؤمنين is mentioned alone, it includes the females also, but when they're mentioned separately, that's to specifically, you know, and bring the attention of both. ثم لم يتوبوا, then they did not repent from التوبة تأوى باء, فلهم, for them is عذاب جهنم, the punishment of جهنم, the hell, and ولهم عذاب الحريق, and the punishment of burning, the punishment of حريق, as a result of what they did to the believers. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات, those who believed and did righteous good deeds as mentioned before, لهم جنات, to them is جنات, gardens, لهم جنات تجري من تحت الأنهار, تجري from جيم رأياء, runs underneath which you know, الأنهار or the rivers, from نون هاء راء, ذلك الفوز, this is the فوز or the success, الكبير, the great success. So as you see here, great benefits from these you know, beautiful verses that shows the reality of the life that we live in, and that we're created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Talks about the hereafter, the virtue of the day of Jumu'ah and Arafah, as it's mentioned in some of the tafsir of the two words that are witnessed, the bala'u, the trials that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might make the believers face, and it's all good for the believers if they're firm upon their faith, and their reward is the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the verses have great glad tidings for the believers, warning the disbelievers, and that what comes afterwards in the batush rabbika lashadid, the punishment of your Lord is shadid, is severe. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from this and to make us among those who are firm and steadfast upon the faith, and not to compromise our deen, and to remember the people of Al-Ukhdud, to how severely they were tested and tried. And when they're firm, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made their test a blessing for them, make them among the people of Jannah. طيب بارك الله فيكم. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala next time with the second part of the Surah Al-Buruj. Wa sallallahu sallam baraka al-Muhammad wa sahbihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.